If you are looking for a rig that is much more or even slightly more than a pavement princess, it can go a little bit off road, get off to maybe the gravel, the dirt roads, maybe some of that washboardy stuff, then there is a world of options out there for you. And we'll talk about two of our favorites today, the MDC trailers and the InTech trailers. So let's talk about that just a little bit, and then we'll look at some of the things that make these a little bit more capable in your off the concrete, off the asphalt situations. Let's go. Now here at Princess Craft, we kind of built our reputation on being, you know, just friends to the niche markets. We covered the lightweight towable trailers, particularly things like teardrop trailers and things like that. But also we became one of Texas's largest truck camper dealerships. You know, the slide-in truck campers, they don't have axles, they don't have wheels, but we love them, so we carried a whole bunch of them, large selection. But when the market started to develop, when manufacturers started coming out with things that are a little bit more off-road capable, we started to go, well, that's a fun niche as well. So we started looking at what they were offering, which is why we're talking today about products like the MDC-USA and the InTech RV. So let's look a little bit at what makes it possible for these trailers to get a little bit off the beaten path to beat their own. When I started looking at talking about this subject, I needed to be a little bit realistic with myself. Throughout all of, history, people have been taking things off road or across continents or across, you know, just expanses of land that weren't really designed for it, and they've proven this possible. Just think, you had wagons, you had, sleds, you had anything that could be pulled by a horse or a mule or a donkey or goats for that matter. People would find a way to drag their stuff, their trailer, their sled all over the place. So much the same, you can find trailers that are not purpose built to go off road in strange remote places. It's been done. My own family would attest to the fact that any redneck can do it. They just have to be smart enough or dumb enough. Take your pick. But that's not the way that we're trying to explore today. Today we're exploring trailers that are meant to be capable. We want to be safe. We want to be wise about it. And so trailers that have some capacity built in to go off-road. So let's look specifically at the strength of the MDC-USA and the InTech when we get started. So right at the baseline, is the trailer foundationally tough enough to pull off the trip? Now, what the MDC-USA trailers have going for it is they're built on this massive galvanized steel, hot roll galvanized, I get the words all mixed up, but it is a massive heavy duty chassis. So therein lies the toughness that you want to build upon. Now, obviously that's about the best thing you can think of, but it is heavy. It's strong, it's heavy. It doesn't allow for too much flex, and you can put a lot of weight on it and drag it with a lot of stresses on it. So there's a good place to look here, but InTech RV does something a little bit differently. Let's walk over here real quick, and you're gonna notice it does have nice sizable beams here in the chassis, but it's done with a different material. So this material is aluminum. There are super strong aluminums out there. Think about these massive jumbo jets and cargo jets and things like that that are built with modern aluminum that can handle incredible stresses and weights and loads and temperatures, you name it. And we're looking at an aluminum chassis that is designed to be strong. They do flex a little bit more. Now, the thing about the steel is that, they galvanized it and they gave it a coating to help protect against stuff like rust. You can get probably a lifetime's worth of use out of it. You just keep an eye on it. And rust is not likely to be much of an issue. But whenever you're dealing with a strong but lightweight chassis like the aluminum, then rust is pretty nearly a non-issue. You still want to keep an idea on anything connected to it, but it's pretty cool. You have other things to think about. Is the aluminum chassis on the InTech as strong and as capable off-road as the MDC-USA? I would venture to say no. If you're really looking at the, let's say the most difficult that you would dare to take in a trailer, then I would look at the super strong steel chassis that you find on a trailer like this. And this is where I still love the InTech, because most of my trips, though I have done some good trips off of gravel and dirt roads and even some washboard roads, it covered that territory beautifully. With my family trips to Arkansas, to Oklahoma, and to Colorado. This was more than enough, even with carrying a couple motorcycles in it. But if you had your druthers on what type of level, because there's a strata, what type of level of off-roading you want to do, think more dramatic, more rock crawling, more difficult, and you think maybe more subtle, entry level, but you can still go so many places if you can get down stuff as difficult as washboard surfaces. So let's look at the coupler points next. Next, we're up here at the coupler point, the connection point to the tow vehicle. So imagine the tow vehicle's over here. Obviously, this is a trailer. This is one thing that's come up in comments before, whenever we've talked about trailers that can go off-road. Now, mind you, when we have this conversation about trailers that can go off-road, we're looking at a pretty wide range of definitions of off-road. Overlanders will get on my case that, you know, if it can't make it down Jeep trails and 4x4 stuff, then it's not off-roading to them. Well, you know, fair enough. Run what you want to run, play the game you want to play. But they do have a good point that you want a lot of articulation if you're dealing with surfaces and terrain that requires it. So look, this DO35 from Cruisemaster that is on the MDC-USA, it obviously has a full 360 degree capacity here. So there you go. But it also has a lot of range here in the tilt. So that is a solid coupling that can handle all the unevenness, because you're going to find uneven terrain even on the pavement, even on asphalt, or even say potholes, or, you know, big bumps that you run across in various places. You know, you have traveled in any state and you found those roads that may be in need of some repair or some maintenance or just some attention. Let's hop on over to what we find on the InTech and discuss what's there and what you might do with it. I'm now in front of the InTech, and you'll notice that it is a standard ball coupler. Perfect for standard trailer pulling. You're gonna find this sort of thing on a bumper pull for anything that is designed to always stay on the pavement, to light duty stuff off pavement. And it's all I've ever used whenever hitting some gravel roads, dirt roads, a little bit of washboard stuff with some mindfulness of where I'm traveling. But if I were to take something that I was wondering if it's going to get a little bit more sketchy, this would not allow for enough movement of that ball before I was risking really hurting something, breaking this mechanism and popping off. So that is that, although popping off of the ball is not common, let's say this is it's worn out on the inside and it just hasn't really been tuned, if you will, then it could happen. So a 360 hitch, it looks like it might not be possible to put a 360 hitch on, but take a look. This is bolted on. And the Flyer lineup from InTech RV has these bolt-on hitches, and you can swap them out for something that has more rotation and more tilt. And one of the easy ones to bring up is the lock and roll system. There are other ones that are super solid as well. This is the first one that comes to mind. It can be changed out for not much difficulty and not much money, so that you can get a little bit more articulation on your travels. All right, I'm underneath the MDC USA trailer, and we're going to talk a little bit about ground clearance and suspension. So obviously in the four-wheeling world, you have to talk about terms like ground clearance. You want a good approach angle, a good departure angle. You don't want a high center. All those things come into play when you want to do more rigorous off-roading. You want to hit some more rutted trails, maybe some rocky, craggy stuff. And that's where a suspension that is capable, like what we find on the MDC-USA, comes into play. These are what they call trailing arm suspension. You're gonna see they have some pretty heavy duty shock absorbers. They have some heavy duty spring systems. That's a chain, heavy duty spring systems. And it's all steel, and it's really incredible. It makes for a nice ride whenever you're on the highway, but it certainly helps out in the way of absorbing impacts and giving you the ground clearance and the control when you're off-road, because that's what it's specifically designed for. So MDC-USA is more geared for the more adventuresome off-roader than the InTech RV, but the InTech RV can still do some pretty neat things. Let's talk about the suspension we find there. Now I'm under the InTech Flyer Discover, which is a personal favorite of mine. It's what my family currently runs. And you'll notice I don't have quite as much ground clearance. We're talking maybe a little over 14-ish inches, but you'll notice that it has some similarities to what we saw underneath the MDC-USA, and some pretty pronounced differences here. You're gonna notice a tube all the way across. Now you would think that might be the axle, but really it's just a tube that allows these things to be installed and calibrated, you know, easily as they attach these to the factory. Because on both sides, it does have a trailing arm right here on both sides, and they do actually articulate separately. So I kind of think of it as a nearly independent suspension. I know that they do 100% flex independently, so that'd be independent suspension. But the fact that they're connected here means that an impact here, where you have your low point, your impact here might cause these things to be slightly affected to each other and maybe a little bit misaligned after an impact. So is it as capable off-road as the MDC suspension? No, but I will say this, the torsion axles have a really good track record off-road. Now, if you're thinking about maintenance on these things, the more moving parts, the more components, the more you want to keep your eye on things, even if it's much more capable or more robust, you just want to keep your eye on it. So the MDC suspension, I would get my eyes on it. I'd be looking at those shocks and probably wash them off and all that on the regular. This is all really straightforward. And from a maintenance standpoint, there's not much you can do. If something goes wrong with this, the beauty of a torsion axle is it's really a bolt-on replacement. Granted, you have to find a way to safely lift your trailer and get the axles off and on, and you don't want to do that on the side of a road. Whereas the MDC suspension, you can do a lot. You can even find a way to safely, let's quote, limp home. You're kind of low on options here. So keep that in mind. But again, hauling my family on camping trips in various places with motorcycles and ATVs and all that, the torsion axle has proven itself quite capable for my family's travels. Now let's talk about the upper portion, the cabin portion of these trailers. This is where they're very similar, actually. They both have aluminum framing for the walls and the roof, the nose and the rear. So they share that in common. Now the difference is that, again, we talked about how the MDC has this steel chassis that skeleton, that aluminum skeleton is sat upon, whereas the InTech RVs, whether it be the Flyers or their other lineups, they call it a welded aluminum cage frame, because the chassis is aluminum and that cage frame, all the walls and roof and all that are welded together and welded to it. So it really is one piece by the time they start putting in appliances and other components. So they're similar, and what I like about that is they've moved away from wood, which of course gives a little bit more flex. In some ways it might or might not, depending on how much metal is used, be heavier. It has its own issues with water intrusion and things like that. So there you go. These both share aluminum framing in the walls, the nose cone, the rear, and the roof. So as I'm bringing this to a close, people do buy these trailers for different purposes. Obviously, you may be looking at off-road and the way you define off-road a little bit differently. So let's start there. How you want to travel, where you want to travel, and with what you want to travel will dictate the fun that you intend to have, and these trailers are purpose-built slightly differently. The MDC-USAs tend to make trailers that are about camping with as a couple or with a family in very rugged, remote places that takes some work to get to. The InTech RVs tend to be about camping in a little bit easier settings, but many of the flyers, as they're built as pretty much open spaces inside, they tend to allow for you to bring other activities with you, whether it be motorcycles or ATVs, side-by-sides, bikes. So you might do events with them. Maybe you're going to the dirt bike track. Maybe you're going to a track day at the actual racetrack. Or I've seen people load these things out with their radio control airplanes. I've seen so many events being attended with the InTech RVs because they're just kind of a big open, make of it what you will. You get to decide what you bring and how you pack and how you organize it for every single trip. The MDC-USA trailers, they're ready to go with some really high-end features. They are fully furnished out. They have great water capacity for gray water and for fresh water. They have all these electronics, big battery banks and battery management systems and all that. So it's a different philosophy on how you're camping. But look at the capabilities of trailers like MDC-USA and InTech RV, because I guarantee you there's something out there in those lineups or out there in general that can meet the type of off-roading and way out there adventures you want to do, whether it be with toys, whether it be solo or with family or larger groups. There's a community for you, and off-roading isn't necessarily the notion I'm going for here, but getting off of your standard asphalt highways and byways kind of path, that is kind of the notion I'm thinking, where you'll travel and see things from smaller roads, dirt roads, gravel roads, unpaved roads, maybe even unmaintained roads, and have yourself some adventures that are deep and meaningful for you and your family. It's been a pleasure showing you these trailers from MDC-USA and from InTech RV. If you'd like to check them out, we have them on our website, princesscraft.com. I'm Clint. We'll see you next time.